in today's landscape and agriculture, it's just really important to talk about soil biology, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's something that a lot of people are learning about for the first time. A lot of people are discovering the need for the first time. But once they have that information, it really solves a lot of problems that they've been having for many years and can sort of alleviate the stress from not knowing what to do and past decisions that haven't been working. It's really the missing piece and big complicated problems for people a lot of the time. Helps them take one step forward and decide what they should be doing next with their land.
Yeah, so it's kind of looking at the soil biology is kind of the missing puzzle piece, right? We've looked at the chemistry for a really long time, but biology like makes everything move and is responsible for all these things, but it's really complex. It's like so dynamic. It's just living, breathing ecosystem. And so to use science to validate what is really going on in the ecosystem as we continue to learn is super powerful. It's the missing link that we've had. And from like a grower standpoint, from, you know, folks that are developing new products, to understand how various chemistry and biological products are influencing the soil biology is just like, it's the next frontier, right? Like it's the next green revolution. It's the next revolution in agriculture is to deeply understand how management practices, how products, how the soil ecosystem is functioning.
So yeah, I think as we talk about soil as a living medium, which it is, it's very important to look at what's living inside and how everything is functioning together. When we talk about chemical and like physical data, it's very important. It's like our, you know, what you're working with, what you're dealing with, and then adding that sort of moving, living functionality piece is what really lets us know, like, okay, how is this all working together? Because we're talking, when we talk about research studies, we're talking about biological data. We know that weather patterns can really affect what's going on with soil. We know that different management practices can really affect what's going on. So looking at a system over a period of years and, you know, as much data as we can gather really helps us tell a story and inform management practices, whether people are deciding to do something new or just evaluating something they've done for a really long time.